Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is decimals part three, and we're going to change the following decimals to fractions and reduce the lowest terms. So you already have to know how to reduce fractions. Right, so here are the first four problems. So let's see, how would we do this? Well, first we need to change it to a decimal, from a decimal to a fraction. And so the number after the decimal point is 32. And there are two numbers after the decimal point, or I should say two digits. So we have a one with two zeros. So that's step one, simply to write it as a fraction. And then reduce it. Now there's different ways to reduce. So some people prime factor and cancel out the factors. Some people think what number goes into both. I think that's the easiest way in this case. I can see that I could divide both the top and bottom by 4. So I'm going to do that. And you don't have to show that step. Some people do it by canceling and having a lot of slashes everywhere. So 32 divided by 4 is 8. And 100 divided by 4 is 25. And so there we have our reduced fraction. All right, put the video on pause and try it on the next three problems. All right, let's do this one. Okay, we have 0.8. What does that mean? Well, it's 8, and there's only one place after the decimal, so you do 1 with 1 0, 8 tenths. That's how you read this number, 8 tenths. And then hopefully that's easier for you to reduce. Divide the top and bottom by 2. Gives you 4/5. Right, next one. What do we have after the decimal point? We've got 525, so we write 525. And let's see, there's one, two, three places after the decimal, so we've got a one with three zeros. Now, this might be harder for you to do in your head, but this is what I see here. I see that 525, and I think money. I think quarters, because I think how many quarters are in a 525? Well, there's four quarters in a dollar, right? So there would be 8 quarters and $2, etc. So basically, if you had 4 quarters by 5, you'd have 20 quarters and $5 and an extra one. So I know that that is 25 times 21, but I'm going to go ahead and write that down. You might not be able to figure it out that way. So another way to do it is you prime factor. You think, well, what number goes into this? So I just figured out that it was 25, and I think that's times 21. And then I could break that into 5 times 5, and this into 3 times 7. Again, writing a number in prime factors is something I do in my other videos as well. Okay, now perhaps you didn't divide by 25, you divided by 5. That doesn't matter. You could have said, well, I know that 5 goes into both of those. So, I mean, 5 goes into 525. That's 105. And then I might say that's 21 times 5, and that's 3 times 7. So, however you want to do it, you can get 5 times 3 times 7 times 5. So, even though I knew it was 25 times 21, I'm going to show you how you could do it by prime factorization. 3 times 5 times 5 times another 7. Now I have to do the same thing with 1,000. All right, now for 1,000, I think of that as 10 times 100 to begin with. And then 100 is 10 times 10. So really you have 10 times 10 times 10. And you could break that all the way down, or you could just put 10 times 10 times 10. I'm looking up here and seeing I'm only going to be able to cancel with the fives anyway. So if you did it this way, what I have left in the numerator is 21. And in the denominator, I have 2 times 2 times 10, that's 40. So this reduces to 21/40. In any case, you can see my videos on how to reduce fractions. There's a lot of different methods people used to reduce, but it is 21/40. Before going on to this last one, I'm going to show you the way I had started off explaining my way of thinking a lot of times is in terms of money. So I thought of doing it this way. I thought there were 21 quarters, so 25 times 25, and then, I mean, times 21, and then I thought about how many quarters are in 1,000, and I think that's going to be 40, because there's 40 in one, there's 4 in $1, so there's going to be 40 in another dollar. And if I did it that way, notice the 25s cancel, and I'm still going to get 21/40. It doesn't matter the method you use to reduce, but in the end, it's going to reduce to 21/40. I'm not sure this fit on the page so well. I'm going to make this just a little bit smaller so you could see it. Okay. So either way you do it, or of course you couldn't have written these tens out as 2 times 5 times 2 times 5 times 2 times 5, and you still are going to get 40 in the denominator when all is said and done. So that was a little bit harder one to reduce. All right, let's do the next one. We had 0.66. All right, so what do we have after the decimal point? We have 66 over 100. All right, I think this is easier to do in our head. See how 2 goes into both of those numbers? So if I divide the top and bottom by 2, again, you don't have to write that out. Like I didn't write 8 tenths. I didn't write that I was dividing the top and bottom by 2. It's okay to just write equals 4 fifths. This gives me 33 fiftieths. So let's see, we got 4 fifths for that one, 21 fortieths for this one, and 33 fiftieths for that one. All right, let's do the next few problems. All right, here are the last 5 problems. Not sure I'll have room to write them all here, but go ahead and try these on your own first. Okay, so we have 0.45. What does that mean? 45 over what? Well, we have 2 places after the decimal, so it's a 1 with 2 zeros. And hopefully you can see that 5 goes into both of these numbers. So if you divide the top by 5, you get 9, and the bottom by 5, you get 20. So that's the reduced form. So we've got the decimal form, the fractional form, and then the reduced form of the fraction. Next one. 0.375. So we have 375. 3 places after the decimal means we have 1 with 3 zeros. And now, this was like that other problem we did. How do you want to do this? Do you want to prime factor it to figure it out? Do you want to just start dividing by 5? Do you want to think of many? It's up to you how you do that. But in any case, you have to come up with a plan. So I'm going to think in terms of quarters. You can go ahead and do this by prime factorization. How many quarters would this be? And it's because, it ends in 75. I know 25 goes into it. So let's see. I've got 4 quarters in a dollar. So in $3, I'd have 4 times 3, 12 quarters, plus 3 more. So that's going to be 15, I think. Or you could just go ahead and do 25 into 375. And in the denominator, I'm going to write this as 10 times 10 times 10. So you could prime factor it all the way, and if you did that, you would have 5 times 5 times 5 times 3, 2 times 5 times 2 times 5 times 2 times 5. I just did it a little bit differently, and I'm going to do canceling instead. So let's see, the 25 and the 10, what goes into both of those? 5 goes into both of those numbers, so I have a 5 and a 2. Okay. Now, I could do the 10 and the 15 here, right? So 5 goes into both of those numbers, 2, and that would be a 3. And then do you notice this 5 and 10 I can cancel one more time? All right, so what do I end up with? This messy thing. I have a 3 in the numerator, and I have an 8 in the denominator. So that's if you happen to do it this way. Now, if you had prime factor it, you have 5 times 5 times 5 times 3. It's a lot less messy, actually. You have 2 times 5 times 2 times 5 times 2 times 5. If you had written it this way, you can cancel those fives, and those fives. And notice you still end up with a 3 in the numerator, and then you got to multiply 2 times 2 times 2 to get your 8. So we're still going to end up with the same answer of 3/8. The point being, there are different ways that people reduce fractions, but they all should end up with the same reduced fraction at the end. All right, let's look at these next three. Hopefully, you've had a chance to try it on your own first. All right, so the first one. Again, it's a number between 0 and 1. There's no whole number part. So we've got 24 over 3 places after the decimal point is a 1 with 3 zeros. And we could prime factor or we could just start canceling. I'm going to prime factor this one. 24 is 6 times 4. So 6 could be written as 2 times 3, and 4 could be written as 2 times 2. So those are the prime factors, the prime factorization of 24. And 1,000 is 10 times 10 times 10, right? I'm going to write it as 2 times 5, that's the first 10. 2 times 5, that's the second 10. And 2 times 5, that's the third 10. And then let's see what cancels. Those 2's cancel. This 3, nothing cancels with that. These 2's cancel. And that 2 also cancels. So I end up with a 3 in the numerator. Remember, if everything cancels out of the numerator, there's always a 1 left up there. And 5 times 5 in the denominator. A lot of times I suggest that people circle what's left. So easy. Oops, in fact, I almost missed one of those 5s. So it's 5 times 5 times 5. Wow, I almost made that mistake. So we have 25 times 5 is 125. So that is the reduced form of 24 thousandths. I think this next one will be a little bit easier. I'm going to use green. All right, so I start off with 82 over 2 places after the decimal. And this one's easier to reduce. They're both even, so I'm just to divide both by 2 and get 41/50. 41's prime, so I know it doesn't reduce any further than that. And the last one. Right, we have 4, and there's 2 places after the decimal, so it's a 1 with 2 zeros. Right now, when you cancel, be careful here. This is what I was talking about. Let's say you did prime factor it, 2 times 2, and the bottom 10 times 10 is 2 times 5, and another 2 times 5. So you can cancel those 2's and those 2's, and be careful, you don't see it, but there's always a times 1 in there. So don't forget, the numerator is still 1 over 25. A lot of people, when they cancel, they actually write 1 and 1 and 1 and 1, but sometimes that gets kind of confusing too. So in the end, this reduces to 1/25. And so there we are. We did 9 problems. We took numbers in decimal form, wrote them as fractions, and reduced. Good practice with fractions. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.